Number of significance is an earthquake that's magnitude 4 or larger. And the one thing that the shake alert system does is that within a few blinks of an eye, it estimates the size of an earthquake. And so it acts very quickly. In this case, it acted within about 4 seconds to produce some information and make it available. So this earthquake wasn't big enough to set off alerts on cell phones, but it was big enough to potentially slow down trains, open firehouse doors. So doing those automated actions where people don't necessarily get involved.
Of course, when this quake first hit, it started off as a 4.2 magnitude quake. It's since been downgraded. With that, though, should that have triggered at 4.2?
Absolutely. And so what happened is the shake alert system, the earthquake early warning system for the West Coast, detected the earthquake. It thought it was a 4.2 to start with because it has to make those calculations very quickly. And then over a few seconds, literally a few seconds later, then the number began to drop a little bit. And this is just a matter of more sensors picking up the earthquake and finding out what it really was. So these adjustments are normal.
So what do we know about this quake in particular? Is it on the Hayward Fault? What can you tell us about the fault? I know a lot of attention's been put on the Hayward Fault because scientists think it's due for a major quake, right?
Absolutely. I mean, it's another major urban fault like many of those in Southern California. And an earthquake like this is just business as usual. It's earthquakes that we have in California that are typical. As far as locating where the earthquake actually was, which fault, the name of the fault, it's within that proximity, but it's going to take a little bit of time to actually to really determine where it is. It's such a small quake.
We understand that this one was relatively shallow. Can you give us some information on that and the widespread nature of how it was felt around the Bay Area?
Yeah, well, you got it right, completely right, that it was a shallow quake. It was only something order 5 miles deep or something like that. And that means that more people are closer to the earthquake. Everybody is within 5 miles of the earthquake, so you feel more. And so you saw some shaking. People felt shaking up to what would be considered light shaking, MMI 4, modified Mercalli intensity 4, fairly close to San Leandro and others. So yes, the shallow earthquake, actually people felt more shaking.
Does the 3.9 quake do anything to lessen the chances of a major quake down the road? Does it reduce some kind of stress on the fault lines there?
Not necessarily, and these small quakes happen all the time. And in general, when you get smaller earthquakes, you get bigger earthquakes that accompany them. So there's not necessarily a relationship between the release of energy from small earthquakes and it preventing a larger earthquake.
Any word on aftershocks?
I haven't really monitored recently, but there may be a few out there. But you know, it's sort of a normal course of affairs to have a few small events afterwards, but I haven't monitored what's been happening since the event.
And I'm curious about the possibility of foreshocks, because during the Ridgecrest quakes, we had a major quake followed by an even larger quake. I mean, is that something to consider here?
It's always something to take in consideration, and I think that really gets people to motivate people to think about what they should be doing to prepare for earthquakes. So, of course, if you get an alert on your phone or if you feel shaking, take that protective action, drop, cover, and hold on. And, you know, download the MyShake app. There's Quake Alert USA. There's a bunch of things out there that you can use to get alerts to be ready for that next earthquake.
One thing we mentioned on our earlier newscast is that these smaller quakes give us all room to remember that we need to have an emergency kit. What kind of advice do you want to give our viewers tonight, since this was a relatively mild quake in the scheme of things? What do you want to say to viewers about getting those kits ready?
Oh, exactly that. I mean, Shake Alert is one tool in the toolbox. Included in that toolbox is having those disaster supplies kits available. Check them out, make sure everything is up to date. It's an opportunity to remember to be ready and to know what to do when something happens, when you get that alert or when you feel shaking. And of course, having those kits put away and all the other things that you're doing to get ready will give you greater peace of mind in the long run.
Bob DeGroote, we really appreciate your time and helping us understand what happened here this evening across the Bay Area. And maybe putting people's minds at ease a little bit about what happened and getting ready for what surely will be a major quake at some point down the road.